One of the areas that we constantly have to deal with in the cloud is the area of cleaning up technical debt. Technical debt is when we've had practices for a long time, or we've designed applications or security principles or something in some way that really is no longer applicable, but it's the way we've always done it, so we're hesitant to change. The reason why this is a problem in the cloud is because in the cloud we really need a different mindset, a different way of approaching IT, and some of this technical debt stuff just really doesn't fit. And in order to improve our processes and scale and be able to do what we want in the cloud, we really have to do the hard thing, and that is change. So we're going to spend the next few minutes today talking about clearing up some of this technical debt in the area of security, specifically on our virtual machines. And we're going to talk about how we can do that today with Azure Active Directory authentication. I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy. This video was requested by one of the members of our community, and if you would like to request a video on something that we haven't covered yet, just leave me a comment below saying what the video topic is and how you think that would help the community, and we'll be happy to create that for you. But to start us off today, let's look at the Azure docs. Now, the docs for Windows and Linux in this case are in a separate location, and I'll show you both of those. But we're going to start by going to Products and then to Linux Virtual Machines. And in the navigation here on the left, we're going to go to the How To Guide. And then we're going to Manage VMs. And then we're going to scroll down a little bit to Sign In with Azure Active Directory Credentials. So the basic approach, whether you're doing this for Windows or Linux, is to increase security on your systems by removing one of those things which has been an attack surface for a long time. And that is the local administrator account. The local admin is a very powerful account because its credentials unlock basically anything on the system. Basically, we're going to have Azure Active Directory use our credentials that already exist in the cloud, which we're going to control through specific RBAC policies that will enable the right people to have the right amount of access on the machine and function as a local admin without needing separate local admin credentials that have to be maintained. Now, there are some requirements here, so let's go to the network requirements link on the right. And basically, these need to have port 443 open outbound from your virtual networks, and you need to be able to hit all of these URLs. So if you're using something like the Azure Firewall, which we did a couple videos on, and you'll find those in the YouTube card up top, you could just use the FQDN filtering on there to make sure that these are allowed outbound. And an important note here for Linux systems, you cannot use a network security group at this point with the VM, because we can't do the FQDN filtering through NSGs. Now, before we go ahead and start building a Linux VM and setting this process up, I want to also show you where the Windows side of the docs are and why they are separate. So we'll scroll all the way back up here and go back to our basic documentation link. Let's go to Products, and then we'll come down to Identity, and then Azure Active Directory. And we'll scroll down to the Device Management section and go in there. And over on the left, we'll go to the How To Guides section, and then we'll click on the Windows, Azure VMs, and Azure AD link. Now, the reason why these are in two separate places is because the Windows implementation here is going to be quite a bit different. And over on the right, if we click the link for requirements, we can see that we've got to have Server 2019 or Windows 10 version 1809 or later. And we have our network requirements, again, port 443 outbound, and we've got to be able to hit these URLs. But there is another note a little further up. And this note tells us that our Windows VMs will be Azure AD joined. So let's jump over to the Azure portal and start getting to work. In the Azure portal, we're going to create a new resource. So we'll click our plus button at the top, and we'll choose a Ubuntu server version 1804. And the full list of which distributions are supported under this feature is in the docs. So we'll go through our initial setup here, and I'll choose my resource group as Azure AD Auth. And I've gone ahead and set the machine name, region, and the size for our VM, as well as put in the local username and password, and allowed port 22, so we can SSH into this machine. Now, I know I said that we're going to basically replace that local admin password, but we still need it as part of the build, and you'll see what I'm talking about in a second. So let's go to the next page, and this is the disk configuration, which I'll just leave alone and hit next for network. And I'll be standing up a new network for this, and so I'll need a public IP to be able to get to the VM. But this all looks good, so I'll hit next. And here under the management tab is where we're going to spend a few moments. So we'll scroll down a little bit here, and we can see Azure Active Directory login with Azure AD credentials, and this is in preview. So we're going to turn this on, and that's what's going to enable us to take advantage of Azure AD authentication on our VM. See, it's really a simple process. And in our auto shutdown section, we'll set our VM to turn off at 11 p.m. And I've set that for the Eastern time zone as well. And we'll hit next for the advanced section. And at this point, there's no changes that we need to make here. So we'll just hit next. And in our tag section, we'll add the appropriate tags. And this is so I know who's going to be paying for these resources, which kind of deployment it is, and what applications we're supporting. And then we'll hit our review and create. And you can review everything, make sure that it looks just the way that you want it. So before we click the create button, we'll click the download template for automation. And this is so you can see what the JSON code is doing. So the virtual machine itself is a absolutely, totally, and completely standard VM. There is nothing special. There's no special settings or configurations that are here. What is special is the last item over here in our resources list, and that is the extension for Azure AD Authentication. Now, this extension, you could just copy this as is and use this in your ARM code going forward. And if you're interested in a Azure CLI or PowerShell for how to do this same kind of deployment, that is in the docs. So let's close this window and hit create. Now, while this VM is creating, let's go over to our resource groups and we'll go to Azure AD Auth. And here I'm going to show you two different ways to set up these VMs with their permissions so that the right folks can log in and no one else will. So we'll go here to the access control and to role assignments. So we'll click at the top here to add a new role assignment. And for the role type, we'll hit the drop down here and scroll down to the bottom. And we're going to use the virtual machine administrator login. And then we can select here the right user to give this permission. And I'll give this to my WVD admin and we'll hit save. And if we scroll down now, we can see we have a virtual machine administrator that's set up for this entire resource group. So any VMs that are here, this guy will be able to log in and administer them. So we'll go back to the overview screen here and it looks like everything's finished deploying. So we'll click on our VM. And then I'll copy our public IP address. And I've opened up PuTTY here and put in my IP address and we'll hit open. So I get my login prompt and I'll put in my Azure AD credentials and we'll hit enter. And now we get the device login prompt. So we need to copy this URL and now we need to enter the code provided for us. And then we'll hit next. And it's prompting us to sign into this Azure VM. So we'll put in our credentials again and hit next. And then we provide our password and hit sign in. And it says we've successfully signed in, so we can close this window. And back in our SSH prompt, we are logged in. And we can type the hostname command, and there we see we're on Linux Azure AD1. And I'll type sudo -s. And in order to provide our credentials, we need to go back to that device login page and enter the new code. And we'll hit next again, sign in with our WVD account. And we've been authenticated, and now we're in as root. Now, this process can, of course, be kind of inconvenient to have to keep bouncing back and forth to a device login page, so we have a way to get around this. And we can do a cat on /etc/sudoers-d Azure AD admins, and we can see we've got %AzureADadmins all equals all here. And if we want, we can replace this with some text that you can find in the Azure docs section that we were just looking at. So let me show you where that is. You can just replace this line of text with this line of text, and then you would not have to enter your password once you have authenticated for the first time. And this is only as an admin. Regular users will still need to provide authentication if they try to sudo. So I'll edit this file in nano, and the change here will just go to add no password. And then we can control O to write out the file, and then we'll just hit enter. And now we can exit, and then we can cat the file again. And now we'll exit as root, and we're back in as WVD admin. Now if I sudo again, I'm in without having to supply credentials. So let's exit and log out. We'll go back to PuTTY now, and we'll log back in using our Azure AD credentials again. And since this is a new login, we'll need our code. And we'll put that code in and hit next. Select our WVD credentials and we are signed in. I'll hit enter a few times on the console and we're back in. So now if I go to sudo dash s, we're right in without having to provide those credentials again. So this gets us in as root, but a regular user would require a different process. So let's go back to the Azure portal, and we can do this directly on the VM. We'll go to access control and role assignments. We'll add a new role assignment, and we'll scroll down here to the very bottom, and we're going to want the virtual machine user login, and this time we'll select Batman as our user, and then we hit refresh here. We can see Batman is now a user on this VM. So this way you can assign Batman or whatever other users you want to log on to each machine. And that's how you can delegate their access to log in while using the resource group or higher at the subscription level in order to delegate those administrator rights. So now we'll log back into that VM. Now this time I'm going to attempt to log in as Superman. And we get our same device login prompt. So I'll take my code here. Now when we tried to log in, we see that access is denied. And that is because we do not have the login rights that we need. So I've loaded a fresh PuTTY session here and we'll log in this time as Batman. We'll copy our code again, hit enter a few times on the console, and we are now logged in as Batman. So we can see controlling this now through RBAC gives us then the ability to manage our logins from the cloud. So let's try to sudo. And when we do, it is prompting us to log in because we are not part of that administrators group and we don't have the rights to just log in. So we've increased security now around our Linux VMs. Let's take a look at how to do this on Windows. So back in Azure now, I've got a Windows VM built, and that was basically done through the same method that we just did for the Linux systems with one little caveat. So we've got to select a compatible image here. So I'll take 2019 data center and then go to the management tab. And of course, we have to select here turning on Azure Active Directory credentials. When we do, watch the Manage System ID. See, that turns on as well. Unlike Linux systems, this is a requirement for Windows systems. And that's because one of the differences here is we are doing an Azure AD join. And we need that managed system ID to do some backend processes. Let me show you what I mean. Back in Azure Active Directory under devices, I've got my VM registered here as an Azure AD joined machine. So when we go back to that VM, and now we go to log on to the VM through our Connect, we'll open up our RDP and we'll open that up. And we should be able to log right in with our Azure AD credentials, right? But no, we cannot. And the reason for this is because the machine that I'm trying to RDP from is not currently Azure AD joined. Now, if you're not familiar with Azure AD joins, this is not like a traditional domain join. It has some of the same features, some of the same benefits, but they don't function exactly the same way. So with an Azure AD join, you're going to have more of like an Intune join type experience. So when I run this particular command, this DSREGCMD, you can see that I am not Azure AD joined on my machine, and my machine's host name is Hal. This machine, because it is not joined, it's not part of the same domain, so I don't have the trusted relationship to be able to log on to the VM directly. However, I can Azure AD join my machine. Here's the help switch for this particular command, and you can see that we can do a slash join in order to become part of our Azure AD environment. Or you can open your Windows settings screen and go to accounts. And under the work or school, you can access a work account this way. So you hit the connect button and then you can provide your email address here, or you can click this link, which is what we will do to join this device to Azure Active Directory. And then we provide our credentials and then we hit next and we put in our password and then we hit the sign in button. And just to verify, we're joining the MS Azure Academy and we've got our credentials. And so we're going to create a user session on this local machine with these credentials and we will be joining as an administrator. And we'll hit join. And we are all set. And when we show the dsreg command now, we are Azure AD joined, and we are joined to the Azure Academy. But when we scroll down, there is this one other feature flag that's important, and that's under our single sign-on state. Currently, single sign-on is not enabled. And that is, again, because the user that I am logged in as is currently my local machine's user, Dean. So I can't use single sign-on right now. That's why it didn't work when I tried to RDP to the VM in the cloud that has Azure AD credentials enabled. So now we've logged in with our MS Azure Academy credentials on the same machine. And when we check the status, we see that we are joined to Azure Active Directory, specifically to the MS Azure Academy. And now our SSO state shows a lot more information, showing that that is enabled as well. Now, since we have this login, we can now do our single sign-on pass-through. Now, when I try to log in with my user, this user does not have access from Azure, but it will see the basic connection, and then it greets us with a message saying that your account is configured to prevent you from using this device. So that's our security feature from Azure. So now if I change the login to my WVD, now I can log in. So if I pull up the command prompt, we see we are logged in with WVD onto our cloud Azure machine. And when we check the status, we see the same thing. Yes, we're joined to Azure AD, to the MS Azure Academy, and then also single sign-on is enabled. So I hope that you've enjoyed looking at this new feature that is in preview, how to use Azure Active Directory to control authentication to your systems. And this should not only help you to increase security across your systems, but also start to alleviate some of that technical debt as you move into the cloud. And so we won't have to manage these local admin accounts because we can control it all from Azure directly. So if you thought that this video was good, please click on the thumbs up icon, as well as click the subscribe button if you haven't already, and join us here at the Azure Academy as we are just trying to help everybody learn all about Azure. While you're down there, go ahead and leave me a comment on this topic or any other that you'd be interested in. Again, this video was created because of a request from our community, and we'll be happy to make yours as well. And if you want to get an email notifying you when our videos come out, which is roughly once a week, you can click on the bell icon as well while you're down there. So thanks very much for joining us this week, and we will see you next time. Happy learning.